गुड डे ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द लिनक्स आइनोड्स. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द आइनोड, हाउ इट कैन बी क्रिएटेड इन द लिनक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. सी, वेन एवर यू क्रिएट ए फाइल, फॉर दैट फाइल इन द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इट मेंटेन्स अ यूनिक आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर. दैट आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर इज कॉल्ड एज इंडेक्स नोड. दिस इंडेक्स नोड इज कॉल्ड एज द आइनोड नंबर. सो all the Linux systems, all the Unix family systems support these Linux inodes, these inodes. And when a file created, the file name only you know, but at the background the inode is created. So whenever you have to access the file, you can use with the name, along with the name the inode number is also displayed. The command which we can view all the inode numbers for each and every file is nothing but ls-l. ls-l stands for long listing, where you can use this command to access various kinds of the files along the file name, but as well as the inode number also. See here the file name, but internally file name is mapped to your inode number. Inode number stands for uniquely created identification number by the system to the specified file. Remember, you only know the name of the file, but internally that name is mapped to the uniquely generated identification number. This uniquely generated identification number can be viewed with the help of ls-l and as well as ls-i. I stands for inode numbers and ls-l stands for long listing. Later sessions we see the commands, then we see what all these options for the ls command. So you know what is the meaning of the Linux inodes, how they can be created. Okay, so now we see how it can be created, how the Linux inodes can be created, what it contains, what kind of the information it contains. See, as we all of you know, inode is a uniquely generated identification number assigned by the system to a file, but internally it will maintain not only the uniquely generated identification number, it maintained in the form of a data structure with the help of some set of the fields. Hence we can call it as a metadata. All of you aware of the metadata, the data about the data. That means whenever you are using a file, it contains a description of the file. So who it created, where it was created, when it was created, all the relevant information regarding that file is called as this particular metadata. So now here we see what kind of the metadata contained in an inode file. See here, see user ID of the file, what is the identification number of the user, what is the group of the user to which he belongs to, that is group ID number, and the device identification number on which device it was created. And next one is file size in bytes. The file size is measured in bytes. Next, the date of creation, on which date it was created. Next, permissions. What are the various permissions of the file? Each and every file can have three number of the permissions: read permission, write permission, and execute permissions. See, this describes whether how many number of the permissions this particular file can have. And who is the owner of the file? The user who create the file, he can be treated as the owner of the file. And next, file protection flag. The file having the protection flag or not. And next, link counter to determine how many number of the hard links that particular file is having. This is described in the link counter. So all these number of the fields are contained in one particular inode field. Okay, so inode is not a single number, actually it is maintained in the form of the data structure in the Linux operating system. Okay, next, creating hard links. How can we create hard links? Normally the links of the files can be created with the help of the ln command. See, whenever you link with one existing file with one new file, the inode number of the existing file and the new file will be same. See, whenever you create that existing file, whenever you delete that existing file, the newly created file will also gone, because both are having the same inode number. Once you delete the inode number, how many number of the files that are mapped to that particular inode number, all these can be deleted. So, these kind of the links are called as the hard links normally. These hard links can be represented with the help of the ln command. Ln command in the Linux is used to create the hard links. That means you can map one file with the another file with the same existing inode number. Remember, though the name of the files are different, but the inode number is same for both the files. Okay, next, how to find the hard links? In our system, how many number of the hard links are there? How many number of such linkings among the files are there? This we can find with the help of the find command. Find command is used to give one particular file is having how many number of the maps. It is mapped to how many number of the files, or one single inode number can be mapped to how many number of the files. Such kind of the information can give. Okay. And remember, don't confuse. One inode number can be mapped to many number of the files, but one single file can be mapped to one particular inode number only. Okay. Next. What are the symbolic links? Symbolic links are differentiated from the hard links. Hard links are different. Hard links directly we can create with the help of ln command. But these symbolic links are the soft links. These we can create with the help of ln-s option. What is the differentiation between a symbolic link and hard link is, they cannot link to the inode numbers on which we have created previously. Okay. They create their own inode number, okay, and then we can identify them with the help of ln-s, and particular file name we can give. That particular number of the symbolic links represented to that file can be displayed. And symbolic link inode is different from the original file inode number. Symbolic links are different. So normally symbolic links, an ordinary user cannot create a symbolic links. Normally permissions are not have. If at all we are having permissions like administrator, and then only we can use the symbolic links. Symbolic links particularly linked with the system files, not with the user files, and they can be very rarely used. What is the difference between hard link and symbolic link is, hard links can be created by the ordinary user with the help of the ln command, whereas symbolic links cannot be created. They can be created, they can be linked with the system files normally. This is nothing but symbolic files. What is the inode number generated by the symbolic links is different from the is different of the inode number of the hard links. This is system generated number, that is also system generated number, but it is the different one. See here, the target permissions are applied to the symbolic link file. So one more differentiation between symbolic link and hard link is, hard links are limited to their own partition of the file system, whereas symbolic links are not limited to one particular partition. They can be limited to any partition in the given file system. And one more command we need to remember here is nothing but RM. RM is the command which is used to remove the files associated with the inode numbers. The same RM command is used to remove the hard links and as well as soft links. And the other thing we have to see here is nothing but each and every Linux operating system file can have three different number of the attributes. These attributes can be again represented as the permissions. As earlier we discussed in the permissions of the file, whereas in the data structure created by the hard link, see here, inode data structure, here we have the permissions. What are the permissions here we discussed? That is read and write and execute permissions. And these permissions we are discussing here. These permissions can also be represented as the attributes. See, the first one is read attribute. Read attribute can be represented as R. That means the file can be allowed as the read only. There is no written and no execute permissions are given. The next one is write permission. Write permission means the file, we can enter some text into that particular file. The next one is, the third one is execute permission. The file can be the executable file, it can be execute. Normally all the files are not executable files. Some text files, all these are not executable files. Executable files are different. They contain some set of the commands, batch files and C files, all these are the executable files. They must have the execute permission. These are the attributes. Now we are going to see the types of the users. How many types of the users? यू जी ओ एंड ए. यू स्टैंड फॉर यूजर दट ओन्स द फाइल एंड जी स्टैंड फॉर ग्रुप ऑफ द यूजर द वेर दैट पर्टिकुलर यूजर बिलोंग्स टू ग्रुप इन विच ग्रुप द फाइल बिलोंग्स टू एंड नेक्स्ट वन ओ द अदर यूजर्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम दट पर्टिकुलर यूजर आर देर एनी अदर यूजर्स एवरी वन एल्स एंड ए मीन्स आल यू जी ओ दीज आर द फोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द यूजर्स यू जी एंड ओ. नेक्स्ट टू चेंज द परमिशंस टू असाइन द परमिशंस टू रिमूव द परमिशंस ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर फाइल वी हैव वन कमांड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज chmod. सी chmod प्लस एक्स यू आर असाइनिंग द एग्जीक्यूट परमिशन ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर फाइल टू ऑल द यूजर्स लाइक यू जी ओ. दिस सिंटैक्स इज एप्लीकेबल दिस पर्टिकुलर सिंटैक्स इज एप्लीकेबल फॉर ऑल because we didn't mention here either u either z either o so this particular syntax is applicable to all. In the same manner the second command also chmod minus x that means you are removing the execute permission of that file and the next one you are assigning the read permission to all the users of the particular file name and finally the last one is you are removing the execute permission for all the users of that particular file name. See the second one and the last one both are same and this applicable to all the users. Previously we have discussed users, groups and others. Okay, so to all the users the permissions either will be assigned or will be removed with the help of this. Next, there is a numeric method for the chmod is also there. That is, you can assign the permissions not only with the help of this plus and minus and these permissions. You can also assign the permissions with the help of numerical things also. How it is that we will see in our next coming video. Thank you for listening.